Each note è legatissimo.
You must get to the point.
That's it.
Beethoven remains constantly contemporary. This music really deals with the completeness and the innermost nature of the human condition. It is about the necessity to push yourself to the limit. It does not shy away from the extremes. That out of chaos, out of strife, comes a new order.
Bravo. Bravo. The many, many, many wonderful things, Salim. Really wonderful, many wonderful things. I think you managed to express the grandeur of the piece which, very, very clearly. That's not easy because it's also it's a very it has a grand structure. It has a lot of grand gestures, dynamically, rhythmically, harmonically, in every way. But it's a very sort of fingery piece at the same time. I think you have to be careful in music that moves at relatively high speed with a pedal. You get excited by the music and without noticing it, probably, your finger goes in the pedal. And also other times you do notice. I think you have to be a little bit more careful with that. And the other thing I think you have to be a little bit more careful is that too often you rely on the pedal for the legato.
Well, I was born in Nazareth, and that's in a Palestinian Arabic town in Israel. There was nothing in Nazareth that had anything to do with classical music. My grandfather had a carpentry in the old city, and where it was very narrow streets, and even cars couldn't come in. And there was Arabic music, and there's, of course, the Muslim call for prayer. And that's what I heard as a child. And my first contact was through a black record that came into our home by chance. I remember that, I still have it, of Joseph Hoffman playing Tchaikovsky Concerto No. 1, of course. It had such a burning attraction to this music, and that I just wanted to be a pianist. It's really hard to explain why, because there was not, I already decided to be a pianist before I even ever saw a pianist, before I ever heard live a pianist. I was more serious when I was 7 years old as I am today. It was just a matter of luck and a very, very intense curiosity on the part of 6 years old. And it's very, very curious. I find it always very, very curious. Why was that?
But, you know, I don't think, you know, you can play something like this and rely only on the pedal that will do it. Because you don't get the fullness of it. You know, you have to really be able to do the finger legato, the hand legato, to its utmost. And only use the pedal to complement that. Sometimes you lose the tension and you lose a little bit the center of the sound because of that. I think the beginning of the piece you start really remarkably well. It's very difficult because it has a feeling of almost of an introduction, which of course it isn't. And then the before the accent, I think you have to play that a little bit shorter, otherwise the accent does not have its full impact. And when you land, I wonder whether it is so good to play those notes so short, because they're in the minor key and you need every element possible to then clear the air for that. And if you play this, it gives it a lightness which does not reflect the tension built up until then and does not allow you to move on. Do you want to try again the beginning? Be careful, the first note is a little bit too loud. You have to really go to the next part. See, I don't hear the bass. You play like this. You need that. Sorry, Salim. Can you make it a little clearly that you go? Now there's a change. How? You you're at the moment, try and play a little bit slower that we, that for us, that we can understand.
Change.
And again. So that you get, really, that you get this. This is the skeleton, this is the anatomy of the passage. And we must really be able to hear that. In other words, this, you have to achieve a greater degree of balance in the left hand. The thumb, of course, is a much heavier finger than the fourth finger, or the little finger. You don't have to underline it, but you have to really make this metric articulation really clear. Try that a little bit. Try that a little bit less pedal. Yes. This is already a lot richer. Now, of course, you're concentrating only on the left hand, and we lose the the sustained of the, also this one. No, this isn't it. You know. Sorry, let me say, it's worth really going to the end. This we talked about, now it moves. See how strange it is. Always when there is a modulation, try, when you practice, play the chord that precedes the modulation, stay on it, and then play the next chord, and you will see how strange it is. That's where you are, and that's where you are going. No, keep the pedal. Play. Now take the pedal off. You see, you must hear that. You must create the illusion that the old chord is still hovering before the next one comes up. And therefore you cannot go in a matter-of-fact situation as if you were continuing. You know, if you were playing. It's okay, but you're going. Must be a moment, a split second of a change of color. That's it. No. This, don't forget, this is an important long note. Yeah. The long note must not be louder. I don't mean that, but you must be constantly aware of the fact that it's a long note, has to last longer, and therefore the accompaniment, if you want, the left hand, has to be a little bit softer at the beginning of the long note, otherwise the long note does not last. The right hand is very clear, but a little bit mechanical because it is stiff. Anything that makes you physically contrived will also contrive the musical expression. There's no expression that you will get with the contrived body. The sense of well-being that comes from tensionless. Probably that is the best word. Yeah. You hear the difference? Really, let the wrist be like the bow arm of a string play. Be careful that you don't accentuate the note before the accent, otherwise you take the accent away. You pop, 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 pop. And then when you get to the, after all this, when it stops, when the harmonic tension stops, this is when you need the most crescendo. And anything but hurry, the more tension you want, go as if you're trying to hold the speed, you know? It's like a car going down and you're trying to hold it that it doesn't run away from you. Don't play. You only lose the tension. You don't get more tension. You know? You have to use every opportunity to make us hear the clashes. So that the ear gets... So many clashes. There's a wealth of richness in that bar, which is not audible if you just go right through. And once you have done that, you arrive. Don't forget that you are playing. But the keys. That's why the notes should not be too short. Mm-hmm. If it was a yum, then you could do that because it is. There's nothing strange about it. It's in the home key of C major. We have already got adjusted to that, and we are there. But here, especially the you must really learn, and that will give you the possibility to then. A strange sort of release. It's not a normal modulation from subdominant or dominant or whatever it is, but it's suddenly a release of tension. It's suddenly the air is clear. You must get a little bit more clarity in the 16. It doesn't have to be like a typewriter, obviously. No, but it cannot also be. It's too nebulous. You must find a mixture of clarity and sustained pianissimo sound. A kind of pianissimo with a lot of tension. Yes. No. It's much too common to change. You know, what does the ear expect? This is what the ear expects. That, you know, you have to go from the standpoint that the ear is the most intelligent organ in the world, knows everything in advance, and remembers everything. So when you get there, the ear remembers. So the ear expects. Instead of which you get. You know, it's like when you are saying something, you say, however. It's the however I miss. It's too slow. Be careful. Yum, bum, bum, bum. That's too soft, Salim. That's too give. Yeah. Release that. Yes. we talked about. Also, second unexpected thing. You don't expect it to go there. And then be careful when you make the crescendo that you don't change the emphasis of the figure. In other words, you play it. So when you play the crescendo, don't play it. It is always. You can make the crescendo, but don't change the emphasis unless you really want to. I don't think you meant to, but you get. And to the end, remember we talked the other day about this, the courage to go to the crescendo or to the end. If you go to the end of a crescendo and have a subito piano, it is always possible, and I would say almost necessary, especially in fast movements, to take just a hair split of a second of time in the air before you make the subito piano, in order to let the ear understand that it was actually going towards forte, and at the last moment it backed away. And therefore you cannot go. It needs a slight break in order for the clarity of the soft sound to be established. This is a very, very, very important moment, because it is a beginning that you, where you have to begin to smell that you are going to E major for the second subject. In here, the dominant of that. Very strange also in here. Again, you see? And he arrives there by going in the direction of A minor. Now you have to really start from a minimum so that you have the possibility to make a huge crescendo and a huge accumulation of tension. Well, you know, it's not. You know, it immediately begins to sound like an etude. Decision when you get a transition into a second subject, which it's obviously not only permissible but almost necessary to make a slight modification in tempo to express the full quality of the music in there. How to make the transition? You know, you're playing the tempo that we were at was that's what you was more or less what you played, and now you want to play. Something like that, no? So you must make sure that you can, you have, you know, all this. This is the point at which the transition really starts. Because here, remember I said to you, I think we must begin to smell the going to E minor. But we have no idea actually how long it's going to take. But when you, this is already affirmative action. Now it, you have these four bars to get from to this, both dynamically, rhythmically, and harmonically. Be careful that you don't get too slow, too soon, and that you then have to come to a grinding halt, and that you, it's a danger. I'm obviously exaggerating. I'm not suggesting for a second you play it. But you must be careful when you make a transition into a new tempo. usually very dangerous to get below the new tempo, because then you are forced to make a new beginning. Mm-hmm. The purpose of a transition is to prepare the change, like a change of light, to prepare the next subject or the next episode. And in order to do that, you must, of course, make that in relation to the character of the next episode. But if you go below that, you're not anymore making a transition, you're making a clear cut. In film, it would be the difference between blending and making a cut. And I don't think this requires a cut. And the proof is that when you played it before, you were so slow that you had to stop on the first note, much too long. And then you gathered the speed again, trying to make it in one line. Transition is very helpful. Say, very helpful that inside you continue hearing the eighth note. Then you will be able to control yourself in the sense of knowing whether you are above or below the tempo that you want to play. And one last thing. Be careful when you get softer that you don't get longer in the notes. You know, you hear, you play, you want to be very affirmative, and therefore you play naturally marcato and short. But when you lose the volume, you must also keep the shortness. Now, look melodically what happens. And there it stays. Be careful that one hears this kind of inner voice, that it stops at the A.
Or you.
Yep, up, up, up. Salim, you will really get more weight in the instrument if you really play here, not so stiff. You know, you're playing like this, you're playing only vertically. Is it? To slow down so much. Why? Because the dynamic control, because the harmonic control and the melodic control is absolutely in one in accordance with the other. This is another point that I feel worth talking about, and that is the relation between content of sound and speed. Very often you ask yourself, at what speed should this piece go? What is the tempo? If you play chamber music, you know, a piece that people don't either know very well or each have played in different groups, the first thing they ask is, what tempo do you want to play this? This is the last question that should be asked, not the first. You can only decide on the speed when you know what the content is going to be. You don't hear speed, but you hear the content in the speed. If the speed is too slow for the content, it all falls apart. If the speed is too fast for the content, you don't understand. In other words, if you were not to make a diminuendo, you would need to make a much bigger retard. Achieve something similar to it. Now you don't have to do that because the diminuendo is there and therefore it takes care of part of it. It's enough. It's enough because of the reaction. But the thought behind it is the same. Okay, please once more. careful. Legato always... Salim, don't forget, legato... Don't forget, legato means bound in Italian, bound. Bound means no air between the notes, and bound also in the tension and in the volume. That means the end of one note and the beginning of the next note must be bound. There must be some connection between them. And it's very dangerous when you have a combination of longer notes and shorter notes to play too loud the first note after the long note. In other words, the beginning of the note is related to the end of what is left of that sound, not to the beginning. It's still not perfect because it's too stiff here. Let the wrist guide your hand where it's going. Yes. Your wrist is the agent you send in advance to know where the hand has to go. Yeah. No, the other way around, the same. Okay. Look, the sound has a tendency to go down, right? So here it goes down, and therefore you have to be careful that the next note is not too loud, otherwise... But when you're making a crescendo, don't forget you have the power of illusion. I believe I'm making a crescendo. I'm hearing this crescendo, and the instrument will follow. So one is reality. Make sure you don't make the long note too long. Wonderful theme, okay, and then you're going all this ornamented, but you have one bar of transition into that. You know, you could have written, he doesn't write that, he writes this bar. This bar is to make possible the difference between and. Therefore, it must have a slight other articulation. It's not legato. It's a transition. Yeah, this is a miniature version of these four bars. You rely only on the pedal. No. It's not. Yes. All we have time for today, to the exposition. But there's some wonderful, really wonderful things. Hmm? I'm very glad we got to talk so much about the textures, because especially as far as the piano is concerned, there is a sort of the belief that you press the key down and that's all you can do with it. And you have shown us how many different possibilities of touch there is, and how the mixture of sustained and articulated sound is possible.
Thank you. So I lied to you. I said yeah, I would be coming to I look for you. My darling, that is the truth.
Honestly,
that is great.
Brilliant.
That's brilliant.
Made it.